This is Getting On With Life, Biblical Wisdom for Successful Christian Living. And this lesson is How the Others Live. People are often comparing themselves with others, hoping to find that they have it better than others. Human tendency to compare with others is celebrated in the old saying, "The other man's grass is always greener." While that preoccupation with comparing and competing is not healthy, there are forms of comparison used in the Bible that we need to pay attention to. Paul drew attention to the old way the people lived. This gives us an insight into how non-believers live and think. In Ephesians 4:17-19, he says, "You must no longer live as the Gentiles do, in the futility of their thinking. Their understanding is darkened, being alienated from the life of God because of their ignorance that is due to the hardness of their hearts. Being past feeling, they give themselves to sensuality, to work all kinds of impurity with greed for more." Unsaved people live lives based on their futile thoughts. That suggests how their inner perceptions of themselves and reality, while quite inaccurate, guide their way of life. But their ability to understand is limited, since they are in the dark. They live without the life of God in their world, because they are ignorant, kept from the truth, due to their unbelieving, hardened heart. They fail to see God or hear God's truth, being blind to it and dismissing it. They have hearts that are hard, not soft. Probably pride and self-will focus them on living for self, so they don't have the soft heart that yields to God and lives for others. Another compromised part of them is their sensitivity. Compared to the sweet sensitivity we have from God, they are cold-hearted and closed. That explains why God-haters can be so callous and hurtful. They lose care for the unborn, disabled, or needy. They become intolerant to those who don't agree with them. They promote terrible treatment of those who do not agree with their policies or values. And worldly people only have one source of joy or fulfillment, which comes from their human instincts. So they are given to sensual values, things that make them feel good. That leads them to all kinds of impurity, including lust, gluttony, vengeance, pride, materialism, greed for power, and so on. That produces the further problem that they cannot feel fulfilled. We know that from Paul's other writings, pointing out that our flesh, our human passions, do not satisfy us, but bring us to destruction. In Romans 8:12-13, Paul said, "So then, brothers, we have no debt to the flesh to live according to its impulses. For if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death your bodily impulses, you will live." Worldly people become increasingly addicted to fleshly indulgence, drawn ever deeper into their lusts, in the hope that eventually they will be satisfied. They simply become all the more deeply enslaved to sin, without getting the joy and fulfillment they seek. So let's take a summary and compare it with how we live in God's kingdom. Rather than live out of futile thinking, we live out of the truth that sets us free. We don't try to figure things out, nor do we chase all the latest popular ideas. We stand on eternal truth, given to us in God's Word, the Bible. We let God transform our thinking and renew our minds, taking the mind of Christ. Our understanding is thus filled with light. We aren't confused by contradictory ideas or half-baked thinking, and our mind is not muddy or misty with vague notions. Instead, we have clarity of definition and purpose, and God illuminates things to us. We are touched by God in our daily life. Our eyes have been opened and we now see the richer reality of this world, including the reality of God and the spirit realm. Rather than miss God's presence, we live with Him daily, able to talk with Him, hear from Him, and receive from Him. Our hearts have become soft and no longer focused on self. We are humbled by the reality of God and we see that our self-directed life was a foolishness we have been saved from. God has given us a new heart that rejoices to be close to God. Ezekiel 36:26 says, "I will also give you a new heart, and I will put a new spirit in you, and I will take away the stony heart out of your flesh, and I will give you a heart of flesh." Rather than have our sensitivities deadened, they are made alive. We are aware of things we previously could not see. We are much more likely to repent and change course as God's Holy Spirit prompts us. We are not only sensitive to people and our world, but to God. We die to our sensual passions, We realize they don't satisfy or fulfill us. We also realize the wonder of spiritual blessings. We abandon living out of our flesh and for selfish and lustful purposes. We put our fleshly motivations to death. Galatians 5:24 says, "Those who belong to Christ Jesus have crucified the flesh with its passions and desires." We abandon sensual and impure living. We have been made clean and holy before God, and we realize the wonder and power of righteousness. We don't deserve to be righteous, but that is God's gift to us because of our faith in Christ. So rather than give ourselves to base and vulgar things, we now aspire to live in holiness and freedom and to glorify God. Our desire is not for empty sensual pursuits, but for the much more fulfilling life in the things of God's Spirit. Our desires have changed, and people around us are surprised that we aren't drawn to the cheap and shallow things they think are so wonderful. Those things just don't satisfy us, and we would much rather live with spiritual graces and God's blessings than human values. 1 Peter 4:4 says, "Your old friends think it strange you do not run with them into the same excess of wild living, speaking evil of you." There is no need to be jealous of others. Their grass may at times seem green, but those outside of Christ are living in a monodimensional world, far from the wonders of God and reality. You are wonderfully blessed to have found Christ and to live for God and with God. So be thankful Christ has set you free, and you are now on a completely different plane of purpose compared with how the others live. God bless you.